The G7 summit is a test for its leadership. Can they solve the world's biggest problems, or will they let them fester again? The success of this summit hinges on this question. And there's a reason why I say this. Some alternatives to the G7 are punching above their weight. Like BRICS, the group of leading emerging economies. This week, the foreign ministers of BRICS nations met. They met in Russia. Indian diplomats attended the meeting. A joint statement was released. The BRICS countries are sending a message to Israel on its Gaza offensive. They want Israel to stop the war. The BRICS has condemned Israel's operations in Rafah. They're concerned about the increasing attacks, the growing death toll, and the humanitarian crisis due to the war. The BRICS nations have slammed Israel for what they call a blatant disregard of international law. And they support full membership of Palestine at the United Nations. Moreover, the statement uses the term occupied, and this choice of words is significant because it paints Israel as the occupier. This is a sweeping criticism of Israel's war. More importantly, India has signed off on this statement. Along with the rest of the BRICS members, India has signed, which is again quite significant because so far India had walked a fine line, balancing both the interests of Israel and Palestinians. When the Hamas attacked Israel, New Delhi called it a terrorist attack, but in the same breath, India backed the two-state solution where Israel and Palestine coexist. Just a few days ago, New Delhi had maintained the same balance while discussing the Israeli attacks on Rafah.
The heartbreaking loss of civilian lives in the displacement camp in Rafah is a matter of deep concern for us. We also note that the Israeli side has already accepted responsibility for it as a tragic incident.
But in Russia, India sided firmly with the BRICS and endorsed the use of harsh language for Israel. Does this mean a shift in India's policy? Well, not exactly. But it does show how the developing world views Israel's war in Gaza. They want it to end soon. The BRICS made progress on other fronts as well. They discussed using their native currencies for trade. They challenged protectionism in global trade and they called for a reform of the World Trade Organization. BRICS nations want special treatment for developing nations at the WTO. By raising these issues, the BRICS is taking an aim at the West and challenging the G7, which is also interesting because barring Russia and China, the other original BRICS members have all been invited to the G7 summit in Italy. South Africa will skip due to domestic reasons, but India and Brazil are attending. Nonetheless, BRICS is carefully positioning itself. Last year, they surpassed the G7 in GDP. Its five original members, Brazil, Russia, India, China, South Africa, contributed more to the global GDP. This is on a purchasing power parity basis. This is a measure of economic productivity and living standards. Now, going by this report, the share of BRICS nations stood at over 31%. What about the G7? The five BRICS countries together contribute nearly 31.5% of the global GDP, compared to 30.7% by G7 countries. Their share was around 30%. Now this year, the BRICS has gotten bigger. It has added five new members, that is Saudi Arabia, Egypt, the UAE, Iran and Ethiopia. This newly expanded BRICS represents over 3.5 billion people and their combined economies are worth more than $28 trillion, which is about 28% of the world's economy. These numbers challenge the economic influence and positioning of the G7. It doesn't represent a large section of the world's population, and it's not being able to solve major global issues. Take the pandemic, for instance. The G7 promised to deliver 1 billion shots to the world. Instead, they kept most of the vaccines for themselves. They did not share the supply. This hoarding may have led to deaths. At least 600,000 lives could have been saved had the vaccines come on time. The G7 has failed to deliver on climate change as well. It promised to provide $100 billion per year for the world's transition away from carbon fuels. So far, they haven't paid up. Now they seem to be heading towards another failure. Recently, the G7 leaders endorsed Biden's truce plan for Gaza, but it has failed to gain traction. The efforts of BRICS leaders, though, are getting attention. The Palestinians have welcomed the BRICS statement on the Gaza war. That was to be expected, of course. One of their diplomats has thanked the BRICS and India for taking a stand against Israel. So here's where we are at. The G7 are neither the richest nor the most influential, which again is a point to ponder for the leadership. Fan of Italy's famous cuisine? Well, we are serving it with a side of diplomacy. As the G7 leaders gather in southern Italy, Vantage is taking you to the heart of the action. What's the agenda? Who is invited? and how is Italy preparing for it? Catch the special edition of Vantage throughout this week, only on First Post. Fan of Italy's famous cuisine? Well, we are serving it with a side of diplomacy. As G7 leaders gather in southern Italy, Vantage is taking you to the heart of the action. What's the agenda? Who's invited? And how is Italy preparing for it? Catch the special edition of Vantage throughout this week, only on First Post.